Chalcolithic. The Chalcolithic, a name derived from the Chalcos, copper and lithos, stone or copper age, also known as the Enealithic or Enealithic, from Latin Aeneas of copper, is an archaeological period that is usually considered to be part of the broader Neolithic, although it was originally defined as a transition between the Neolithic and the Bronze Age. In the context of Eastern European archaeology, the term Enealithic is often preferred to Chalcolithic and other alternatives. The Chalcolithic was a period in which copper is predominant in metalworking technology. Hence it was the period before it was discovered that adding tin to copper formed bronze, a harder and stronger metal. The archaeological site of Belovod, on Rudnik Mountain in Serbia has the oldest securely dated evidence of copper smelting, from 7000 BP, 5000 BCE. The Copper Age in the ancient Near East began in the late 5th millennium BCE and lasted for about a millennium before it gave rise to the early Bronze Age. The transition from the European Copper Age to Bronze Age Europe occurs about the same time, between the late 5th and the late 3rd millennia BCE. The multiple names result from multiple recognitions of the period. Originally, the term Bronze Age meant that either copper or bronze was being used as the age of hard substance for the manufacture of tools and weapons. In 1881, John Evans recognized that use of copper often preceded the use of bronze, and distinguished between a transitional copper age and the Bronze Age proper. He did not include the transitional period in the three-age system of early, middle, and late Bronze Age, but placed it outside the tripartite system, at its beginning. He did not, however, present it as a fourth age but chose to retain the traditional tripartite system. In 1884, Gaetano Chirassai, perhaps following the lead of Evans, renamed it in Italian as the Enealitica, or bronze-stone transition. The phrase was never intended to mean that the period was the only one in which both bronze and stone were used. The Copper Age features the use of copper, excluding bronze. Moreover, stone continued to be used throughout both the Bronze Age and the Iron Age. The part Lithica simply names the Stone Age as the point from which the transition began and is not another lithic age. Subsequently, British scholars used either Evans's Copper Age or the term Enealithic, or Enealithic, a translation of Chirassai's Enealitica. After several years, a number of complaints appeared in the literature that Enealithic seemed to the untrained eye to be produced from Enealithic, outside the Neolithic, clearly not a definitive characterization of the Copper Age. Around 1900, many writers began to substitute Chalcolithic for Enealithic, to avoid the false segmentation. It was then that the misunderstanding began among those who did not know Italian. The Chalcolithic was seen as a new lithic age, a part of the Stone Age in which copper was used, which may appear paradoxical. Today, Copper Age, Enealithic and Chalcolithic are used synonymously to mean Evans's original definition of Copper Age. The literature of European archaeology in general avoids the use of Chalcolithic, the term Copper Age is preferred, whereas Middle Eastern archaeologists regularly use it. Chalcolithic is not generally used by British prehistorians, who disagree as to whether it applies in the British context. The emergence of metallurgy may have occurred first in the Fertile Crescent. The earliest use of lead is documented here from the late Neolithic settlement of Urim Tepe in Iraq. The earliest lead, pb. Finds in the ancient Near East are a 6th millennium BC bangle from Urim Tepe in northern Iraq and a slightly later conical lead piece from Halaf period Arpatia, near Mosul. As native lead is extremely rare, such artifacts raise the possibility that lead smelting may have begun even before copper smelting. Copper smelting is also documented at this site at about the same time period, soon after 6000 BC, although the use of lead seems to precede copper smelting. Early metallurgy is also documented at the nearby site of Tell Mausolea, which seems to be dated even earlier, and completely lacks pottery. Analysis of stone tool assemblages from sites on the Tehran Plain, in Iran, has illustrated the effects of the introduction of copper working technologies once in place systems of lithic craft specialists and raw materials. Networks of exchange and specialized processing and production that had evolved during Neolithic seem to have collapsed by the Middle Chalcolithic, 4500 to 3500 BCE, and been replaced by the use of local materials by a primarily household-based production of stone tools. The Timna Valley contains evidence of copper mining in 7000 to 5000 BCE. The process of transition from Neolithic to Chalcolithic in the Middle East is characterized in archaeological stone tool assemblages by a decline in high-quality raw material procurement and use. This dramatic shift is seen throughout the region, including the Tehran Plain, Iran. Here, Analysis of 6 archaeological sites determined a marked downward trend in not only material quality, but also in aesthetic variation in the lithic artifacts. Faisli et al. Use these results as evidence of the loss of craft specialization caused by increased use of copper tools. An archaeological site in Serbia contains the oldest securely dated evidence of coppermaking from 7,500 years ago. The find in June 2010 extends the known record of copper smelting by about 800 years, and suggests that copper smelting may have been invented in separate parts of Asia and Europe at that time rather than spreading from a single source. In Serbia, a copper axe was found at Prokupiali, which indicates use of metal in Europe by 7,500 years ago, 5,500 BCE, many years earlier than previously believed. Knowledge of the use of copper was far more widespread than the metal itself. The European battle axe culture used stone axes modeled on copper axes, even with imitation mold marks carved in the stone. Tutsi the Iceman, who was found in the Ostal Alps in 1991 and whose remains were dated to about 3300 BCE, was found with a Munzee copper axe. Examples of chalcolithic cultures in Europe include Vila Nova de São Pedro and Los Milhares on the Iberian Peninsula. Pottery of the Beaker people has been found at both sites, dating to several centuries after copper working began there. The Beaker culture appears to have spread copper and bronze technologies in Europe, along with Indo-European languages. In Britain, copper was used between the 25th and 22nd centuries BCE, but some archaeologists do not recognize a British chalcolithic because production and use was on a small scale. According to Parpola, 2005, ceramic similarities between the Indus civilization, southern Turkmenistan, and northern Iran during 4300 to 3300 BCE of the Chalcolithic period suggest considerable mobility and trade. The term Chalcolithic has also been used in the context of the South Asian Stone Age. In Birana, the earliest Indus civilization site, copper bangles and arrowheads were found. The inhabitants of Mehrgarh in present-day Pakistan fashioned tools with local copper ore between 7000 to 3300 BCE. At the Nasharo site dated to 4500 years ago, a pottery workshop in province of Balochistan, Pakistan, were unearthed 12 blades or blade fragments. These blades are long and relatively thin. Archaeological experiments show that these blades were made with a copper indenter and functioned as a potter's tool to trim and shape unfired pottery. Petrographic analysis indicates local pottery manufacturing, but also reveals the existence of a few exotic black-slipped pottery items from the Indus Valley. There was an independent invention of copper and bronze smelting first by Andean civilizations in South America, extended later by sea commerce to the Mesoamerican civilization in West Mexico, see metallurgy in pre-Columbian America and metallurgy in pre-Columbian Mesoamerica. The term Chalcolithic is also applied to American civilizations that already used copper and copper alloys thousands of years before the European migration. Besides cultures in the Andes and Mesoamerica, the old copper complex, centered in the upper Great Lakes region, present-day Michigan and Wisconsin in the United States, mined and fabricated copper as tools, weapons, and personal ornaments. The evidence of smelting or alloying that has been found is subject to some dispute, and a common assumption by archaeologists is that objects were cold worked into shape. Artifacts from some of these sites have been dated to 4000 to 1000 BCE, making them some of the oldest Chalcolithic sites in the world. Furthermore, some archaeologists find artifactual and structural evidence of casting by Hopewellian and Mississippian peoples to be demonstrated in the archaeological record. In the 5th millennium BCE, copper artifacts start to appear in East Asia, such as in the Jiangxi and Hongshan cultures, but those metal artifacts were not widespread. In the region of the Air Mountains in Niger, we have the development of independent copper smelting between 3000 and 2500 BCE. The process was not in a developed state, indicating smelting was not foreign. It became mature about 1500 BCE. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.